Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Show It Better. Today we are going to see how to create a rendered style plan in Photoshop. So we're going to do this only with AutoCAD and Photoshop. So you have your plan in AutoCAD and export it in a PDF in a decent size and import it to Photoshop. I had it, as you guys can see, I had it in color, I had it with the background. So what we're going to do is with the lasso tool, we are going to separate all the context from the normal plan, right? So after we separated it, we are going to start selecting first the walls, then the floor, then the windows, etc., etc., etc. So first we're going to select all the walls. I do this with the marquee tool. You can press M on your keyboard, or you can do this with the lasso tool as well. And when you have all the walls selected, you will create a new layer and you will fill all these walls black. And basically that's going to be the process for each layer, right? So we're going to create a new layer, select the floor, and either we import a texture or we color it from our Photoshop plan. So as you guys can see, I'm selecting the floor right now. So I look for wood floor texture on Google and I select the image that is more close to what I am looking for, right? So there are various ways to get all of this, but I don't know, I think Google is a very good resource to get all of your images. That's basically what I did for this video. I used all the images from Google, and once you have all the images selected, you select the whole floor area and you create a mask. You just create a mask, and what this will do will be that it will show only the parts that you want the floor to be shown in, right? So this type of floor plan is not your normal type of floor plan. This is a floor plan that is very useful when you're at your architectural office, or this is something you have to show to a client, because normally clients want to see more realistic stuff. When you're in university, you're in college, you're doing competitions, you try to do more abstract stuff, things that, you know, are monochromatic, that are more coolish looking. But when you get to the real world, more or less to say it, you know, clients are not architects. They just want to see, hey, what material is my floor going to be in? Where's my couch? Like, how is it going to look? So you want to get a very realistic feel. So you can do this by, if you have a 3D model, you can render your 3D model in the plan section, in the plan view, and show it like that. Or you can do this other option, which is fine as well. But this is the type of plan you will see a lot when you're selling apartments, etc., etc. So this is more for kind of the real world type of plan, right? Also, if you guys want to download this file, this plan, so you can see all the textures, maybe use some textures from for your own plan, you can do it. There's a link in the description. I've also want to thank all of you for subscribing to my channel. If you haven't subscribed, click the red button and turn on the post notification so you guys can see every time I post. You guys can also follow me on Instagram at Let's Show It Better, or on Facebook also at Let's Show It Better. I've been really grateful with you guys. Seriously, it's been amazing this whole ride, and I just want to thank you all for supporting Show It Better and for sharing the videos. Also, if you guys want to support me on Patreon, So as you guys can see, when we're starting to import things that are not textures but objects, it is also very, it's also a thing that you can find a lot in Google, right? So before it was way much harder to find these type of images, but right now it's very easy. So you just, as you guys can see, you put, I don't know, sink top view, bed top view, double bed top view, single bed top view, toilet top view. And you will get different types of toilets, different types of objects. Now, there may be a situation where you're doing specific things where with specific materials, with specific objects, and this will not be as easy. So then in that moment, I do recommend maybe modeling in 3D and rendering the top view of something. But I think generally for these type of plans, those generic images will do to a point, right? Also, if you guys want to comment down below what type of videos you would like to see, it would be greatly appreciated. I have planned in my schedule to do videos on presentation boards and videos on my portfolio. I just want to gather a lot of information up so it can be a very complete video. But I do hear you guys, and yeah. Also, for those of you who really want to see the video in a slower pace, I know there's always many of you, you can slow down the video in your YouTube settings. Although, it's not really the point, you know, you're not going to get a lot of information by slowing down the video. The idea is that you guys try to do this in your house by yourselves, maybe pause the video and, you know, try to do it. That's like the way you have to learn some stuff, right? Now, as you guys can see here for the stairs, we are starting to apply shadows. So what I do in this specific point is with the burn tool, which is not, you know, the best way to do it, but with the burn tool, you can press O on your keyboard and you select the parts that are gonna be, you know, with the shadows, right? And also, you know, alongside the walls, in the floor, what I did was manage the burn tool and just burn a little bit of shadows so it would look more like a rendered plan, right? Because if not, I mean, it's also acceptable if you want to leave it flat, but I think this will give it a kind of depth and to understand different planes of materials of, you know, different heights of things. So basically, yeah, that's what I did, and that's what I recommend you guys doing. Once you have the shadows of the table, of the couch, of everything, it will give much more. It will have a clearer punch to the whole plan, floor plan. So yeah, basically that is it for today's video. I hope you guys liked it. Remember to like this video, comment down below what video you would like to see in the future, and or what, maybe it's not a tutorial, maybe, hey, why don't you talk about your computer settings, why don't you talk about something else, and I will sure I will try to follow your comments and do them. Also remember to follow me at in Instagram at Let's Show It Better and Facebook at Let's Show It Better. There are a lot of nice previews over there if you guys want to see. All right, thank you for watching. Bye.